It was a rough night. Here's the plan. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks, desserts, all keto and low carb. And when I get done with breakfast, I'm going to hop back on here and fill you in on exactly what went down yesterday. Because truthfully, it's just, I don't even know what to say. I'll see. Oh, it's going to be one of those days. I'm going to go fix me something to eat and I'll be right back. This morning, I'm going high total carb, but still low net carb. I'm going to toast a Sola Everything Bagel. Normally, I'll just have half of one of these, but today we're doing the whole thing. 33 total carbs and 7 net carbs. I scrambled 1 egg, 4 pieces of bacon, and then I added a slice of cheese. Breakfast this morning is under 10 net carbs. And to drink, I'm just going to be having some water. I feel like I'm moving in slow motion, like I'm trying to run while I'm underwater. And it's like I just can't propel myself forward. I've not had an experience like this in several months. Not since starting the Omnipod insulin pump. I'm trying to not seem like a drama queen. I'm trying to hold my emotions back, but it's hard. Let me stop a second. Okay, let's just go over what I'm drinking. That way I can start over and not get emotional. While we're chatting, I'm still sipping on my water. I'm just gonna refill this throughout the day and get in as much as possible. I do feel the need for some caffeine. This one is a new one, and I guess we'll do a review while we sit here. Celsius Essentials. I don't know what the essentials are, but I guess we'll find out together. Flavor, Orange Sickle. Energy Plus, Essential Performance, Zero Sugar, 16-ounce can. 270 milligrams of caffeine. It has aminos, and it is kosher. Okay, there's a checklist. Accelerates metabolism, physical and cognitive performance. You may be my new best friend if you do help with my cognitive performance, because I do need it today. Ooh, 7 essential vitamins. As far as nutritional facts, this is your serving. It's going to have 10 calories, 0 fat, 0 protein, 0 carbs, 5 milligrams of sodium. These were at Walmart for $1.88. Before I open it, I'm going to drop it down in my little Yeti can cooler so that it stays chilled all day long. I don't drink these all at once. I sip on them pretty much all day. Ooh, it's got a black top on it. Why have they started putting black tops on them? Is it so you can't see the dirt? I'm gonna wipe it off. Let's give it the sniff test. Smells like orange. It reminds me of a Sunkist, a Crush, you know, your typical orange flavored drink. I can't see if there's any color to it because the lid is black. Sippy sippy. Okay, I don't know, probably not the best time to be doing a review, but I wanted caffeine and I wanted something different. The orange, in my opinion, is not spectacular, you know, a 10 out of 10, but it's also not a 1, 2, or 3. It's mediocre, but it's not so delicious that I'm gonna go buy a dozen of them. TMI alert. So if you don't want to hear this, I suggest you skipping forward. I can't even believe I'm going to share this. What am I thinking? Apparently I'm not. So when I said probably not the best time for me to be doing any type of review, that's because nothing tastes right to me at the moment. That's because I have thrush. No, I'm not an infant. Apparently, type 1 diabetics are more susceptible to getting it. That's because high levels of sugar in your blood also lead to high levels of sugar in your sweat, your urine, and, yep, you guessed it, your saliva. I knew something was going on because nothing tasted right. Just everything was a little off. White, patchy, pink colored tongue. Not like this thick coating or anything. Not even a tongue scraper will, you know, do anything. It's just, it's like my taste buds are white. And then I'll have some pink patches on it. The roof of my mouth is irritated. It's like I've ate an entire box of Captain Crunch. In the corners of my mouth right here had started splitting open. I'm gonna show you my tongue. It's not bad. It's weird, I know. But I feel like I need to show things like this just in case somebody else is experiencing it, because I didn't know what was going on. Google, you know how that is, it gave me every worst possible diagnosis ever. Go away if you don't want to see my white tongue. Well, I didn't plan on talking about thrush, but I guess if my experience helps somebody figure out what's going on with them just a little quicker, then it's a good thing. The original topic for this morning's conversation was going to be about what happened last night. Let me rewind really quickly. My husband Chris just left about 24 hours ago at this point. He headed up to New York for a job. He's been home since the first week of July, so 7 months. The reason he came home in the first place was because I was found unresponsive. Late one night, I was laying right here watching TV, and my blood sugar dropped down into the 20s. Chris had been trying to get in touch with me to tell me goodnight, and when I wouldn't answer, he knew something was wrong. Our 15-year-old had already went up to bed and was asleep. He immediately called her and said, "Can you go check on your mom?" She tried to wake me up because she thought I was just asleep, but nothing was happening. So when Briley couldn't get me to wake up, she called my 27-year-old, who just lives 5 minutes away. When he couldn't wake me, he did a finger stick and the blood glucose monitor would not even register. He called 911 and they came and helped. Apparently, I had been laying there unconscious for 3 hours, and it had took EMS about another 2 hours before they were able to get me to start talking to them, become more responsive. That was the night that Chris got in the car and drove straight back home, and he's been here ever since. I was able to go on the Omnipod insulin pump this past November, and things have been doing great until last night. Here we go again. Now, I want to remind you that during this incident in July and last night's incident, I have been wearing a continuous glucose monitor that gives alerts. Here's what happened. I went to bed. Everything was fine. I woke up at about 3 o'clock. I remember just laying there in a daze, and I ended up probably laying there for about 15 minutes or longer before I even thought, okay, something must be wrong. But I'd also realized I got my blood sugar monitor on. When my blood sugar goes low, it alerts me by beeping. But I was drenched in sweat. Rolled over and grabbed my phone just to go ahead and give it a check. I thought maybe I'm in like the 70s and it's just not went off and gave me the alert yet. When I picked up my phone, it was doing an update. And it had been for over an hour, which means that it would not be able to alert me of a blood sugar low. My phone has never done an update on its own without asking me beforehand. This time, no, nothing. Because there's no way I would want an update at 2 or 3 a.m. It was a little after 3 when I picked up my phone and I saw that it was updating. And that's when it went into restart mode. The update was done. And my phone just starts giving me this blaring, beeping alert that tells me I have an urgent low. It's not even registering a number. It just says low, which means it's below 40. Brain, still not functioning properly because my blood sugar has been low for quite some time at this point. And I just reach into my nightstand and grab a handful of jelly beans. Pure sugar. I'm digesting it pretty quickly, and so it should take effect within a matter of minutes. I lay there and give it a few seconds, eat 10 more jelly beans because still not feeling good. I'd say another 15 minutes go by, and that's when I realize my blood sugar monitor, the one where I stick my finger myself, is in my nightstand. So I pull that out, do a finger stick, and 15 minutes after eating two handfuls of jelly beans, my blood sugar number is only at 43. On here, it's still registering low because the Dexcom is 10 minutes behind. So it looks like I was probably in the 20s or 30s. I got up out of bed, went to the kitchen, and just started going through my 15-year-old's drawer of snacks and just eating everything I could get a hold of. I don't even know what I ate at this point because my brain was in panic mode. By around 3:35, I had it back up to over 100, and I just crashed and went to bed. Now I'm back into the what if. What if I hadn't have woke up? What if Briley would have found me like that again? What if I would have not checked my blood sugar or woke up, or worse? A low, when it gets to a certain number, it's lights out. So yeah, I'm back in that mindset. Hopefully it was a fluke. Heed my warning, people. If you wear a blood glucose monitor, a CGM, if you have something that gives you alerts when your blood sugar is low like that, go into the settings on your phone quite often, probably every single night would be a good idea, and make sure that it's not changed the settings on your updates, because I had mine fixed so that it wouldn't do updates in the middle of the night, but at some point it must have reset, and I didn't know that was a thing. So of course I got up this morning and took care of it, which I should have done last night, but my brain just wasn't in the right place. So now I've got it set to do updates at noon. I don't know how long it's going to take me to start feeling better again. I got the pounding headache. I feel this tightness in my chest, which could easily be anxiety. Just when I thought everything was, you know, getting back to some sort of a new normal for me, then boom, here we go. That's the reason I decided to eat breakfast this morning, because my blood sugar's just been all over the place since last night's incident. When I got back this morning from taking Briley to school, I was at 58. And that's when I realized, okay, here we go, breakfast time. And I just started eating. Today's chat took place early, but I'll be back in a minute with lunch and snacks and desserts and dinner and anything else that may take place. I just got the alert from my Dexcom that if I don't act now, a low blood sugar is coming. So I guess it's time to eat. Luckily, I have leftovers, so all I have to do is throw them in the air fryer. I've been cleaning out my fridge and freezer. The Quest Meat Lovers Loaded Pizza had migrated its way all the way to the bottom. The only thing that I add is additional mozzarella cheese. A third of a pizza is 270 calories, 17 total carbs, but only 5 net carbs. Being completely honest with you, these are not my favorite low-carb pizzas, but these are around $8.50, and I didn't want to waste it. A little tip when it comes to pizzas, rewarm them in the air fryer. They won't get soggy like they do in the microwave. Since I was not a huge fan of the orange sickle Celsius, I didn't drink it, but I did feel the need for something orange, so I grabbed an orange crush, zero sugar. And there you have it, my quick and simple lunch for the day. It's time for dinner, and it's one of my family's favorite recipes. We had it before Chris left, and the kids have already asked me to make it again. Egg roll in a bowl. such an easy recipe. What I'm going to do is link it for you up in the cards and down in the description box. The main ingredient is going to be cabbage. For convenience sake, I just pick up the tricolor coleslaw mix at Walmart. You'll need garlic powder, soy sauce, and an egg, plus your meat of choice. Today I'm using shredded chicken. Dump the slaw mix into a large pan and add soy sauce. Let that cook, then I add my egg and scramble that up. I mix it in and then add my chicken. It's that simple. We like to top it off with the yum yum sauce. This stuff is amazing. The video that I'll link for this will have the recipe in the description box. That way you can screenshot it. And you will want to save that yum yum sauce recipe because my kids add it to everything. Quick and easy dinner. To drink, I'm going to have water. Plus, since I already know I like to have something sweet right after I eat dinner, I'm going to grab a little square of Chalk Zero. This one just recently came in the keto crate. 3 squares is a serving with 16 total carbs and 2 net carbs, meaning 1 square is less than 1 net carb. Don't forget about that Chalk Zero discount code that's going to be down in the description box. Go check out their deals section. Those markdowns are constantly changing. Add the discount to that and you're going to be able to save a ton of money. I hate to just end so abruptly, but I am exhausted tonight. So when I get done, I think I'm just going to go on to bed. Thanks for hanging out with me today. Everything that I mentioned will be down in the description box along with a ton of discount codes. And in case nobody has told you today, everything's going to be okay. And I love you. See you next time.